Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning, people of God. Wow, there's so much to talk about. I have so many things to say. I'm not done yet. I still have two more days to go for my fast. But I wanted to do just one video today and share with you what I saw. Because it's we need to know. We need to know, we need to understand. In order for us to know where we are, we need to know where we came from, and that way when we get where we're going, we are going to understand that we are home, we've made it. So I wanted to share with you because I was praying for Africa and for people of African descent, asking God, you know, what's going on. And I finished praying, I went to bed, I went to sleep. I'm sleeping on the floor because I'm fasting. And I see myself in a very nice house. It was a cocktail kind of atmosphere, you know, with music in the background and people just mingling and going from group to group and talking and all that. And they were just chatting and talking. It was a very civilized party. And then my eyes were drawn on the balcony. We had sliding doors, many of them, and I saw black people. Black people, they were outside and looking in, you know, like they were looking. And they were talking. I wish I could have that. But they were outside, they were not inside. And I didn't understand that. I woke up, I was like, Holy Spirit, what does it mean? This means something, but I didn't know how to take it, which direction to go. And then I dozed off again. I see myself dressed like a housekeeper with a simple dress and then an apron, and I was sweeping the floor. And it was really dusty, and the dust were coming up. I was like, okay, I should have used a mask to protect my nose because I'm going to start sneezing because of the dust that was there. And then at one point I was like, okay, I've walked enough, this is it, I'm stopping. And I stopped. I was removing my apron. I see this woman coming. She was a mixed woman dressed like an African. She said, where are you going? I said, I've walked enough, I'm leaving. She said, no, you're not going. I said, I am, and I'm leaving, it's too much. She said, you're not going anywhere because you don't understand that you are my maid. You are supposed to be under me. And I was like, why is that? She said, first of all, you owe me money. You owe me, so you have to pay. And as long as you haven't paid, you cannot leave. That's one. But two, I'm quoting what she told me. Our fathers, meaning the white side, are the children of Satan. And they gave us this place so that they are on top. And when you, the African countries, started asking for your independence during the 60s, they gave it to you, but they left us here so that we are going to rule over you and you are going to be beneath us. And out of the blue, I see my mother. My mother passed away years ago, and she handed me $300, three bills. But they were open, they were not one on top of the other because that was a weird way, but I took it and I put it on the table. I told the lady, the mixed woman, I told her, I'm leaving there, you have your money, I paid you, I'm leaving. And I picked up my purse and I said, we are leaving. And that's when I saw that I had thousands and thousands of people behind me, male, female, young, old, I don't know who they were, but what we had in common is that they had melanin, and we left. We left like that. I opened doors. I pushed both doors because we were so many people and we wanted to leave. She was mad, making faces, shaking of anger. You know, like in cartoons when someone is really mad at you but they cannot stop you. That kind of attitude. And that was the first part. So I sat, I was like, Holy Spirit, what does it mean? So he told me, he said, the group that you saw, the black people that were on the balcony, they were African Americans, okay? They were speaking English, American English. They are the African Americans. And when they were brought here in America, they were brought here to be slaves. They worked, they died, they sweated, and they bled, and they built this country. So they did that. And that's what you're seeing. But in exchange, you had a group of white people who closed the door. Like they are supposed to remain outside. They cannot come in and enjoy the American dream. That was the room that I saw with that cocktail and all that. So the Holy Spirit told me, he said, open the door. And I opened that door and they were able to come in. And white people were like, very mad. They were not happy to see that, but they could not stop it. Then I hear a word say, a voice say, this program just expired. Because just like you purchase a medicine at in a drugstore, I don't know, something for headaches, or there is always an expiration date. Or food, there is always an expiration date. They will tell you, use, buy, and then you know that this is the expiration date. So the Holy Spirit told me, said that program, that plan, is expiring today. Okay, that was the first part. And then the second part, the one where I saw with that mixed woman, the Holy Spirit told me, said what she told you is true, is the truth. During the 60s, the European that were colonizing Africa were not happy to give you your independence collectively. So they left, but they left many issues, social issues, in behind them. And that's what we are seeing, that's what we are living even today. So they took that plantation mentality that you have the white person on top, you had the mixed people, and most of them were slave house or slave Negroes or overseer. And they will have it better, they will live well, eat well. And the black people, the darker you were, you would be in the field under the sun, toiling and working. That's what they did. So that plan that was established here in America, they took it and they placed it everywhere. If you go to Brazil, we'll see the same thing. If you go in the Caribbean, you go to Haiti, you will see the same thing. Actually, when you see to the way that Toussaint Louverture and Jean-Jacques Dessalines were really being sabotaged by the white, by the mixed Haitian population, you see the same pattern everywhere. And so that's what we had in Africa too. And the goal was to keep African people at the bottom, mixed people on top, and white people on top. So the Holy Spirit told me, he said, repeat after me, I prayed, I declared, and I decreed, and I called that expired. And then I realized that we need to do the same thing for Chinese people, for Indian people, leaving India, coming to Africa. We need to do the same thing for any kind of Caucasian person coming on African soil, and we need to do that even in the context of the Catholic Church. And so I prayed, I declared, I proclaimed, and I destroyed all that in the name of Jesus. But more than that, I came to the realization that African people don't have many friends. I'm saying this with a straight face. I'm willing to debate, I'm willing to talk. African people don't have friends. I'm talking about genuine friends. Someone that you can call at midnight, you know, and say, help, I need help. We don't have many friends. People that are coming to us are coming like pimps. They are coming for their own benefit. They are coming for their own interest. They are coming to take something from us. And when you have enough, then they go. They are not coming for out of love or out of care or, you know. So that's what I discovered. And that's what I saw. So I prayed, and I called that expired. But the reason why I'm sharing this with you is that we need to understand, we need to know, because these modern times where we are, we tend to think that life is just today. Right now it's almost noon here in Southern California, and then by midnight the day will be over and another day begins. No, we need to take it and see that life as we are living is a continuation of time, studied a long time ago, and I'm fighting battles today that studied a long time ago. I have enemies today that studied, that were my enemies from a long time ago. It didn't start today. That's what I'm saying. And so we need to know where we're going, because we need to know where we came from and where we are going. And that's where we are. That's what I saw. That's what I wanted to share with you. And it's very interesting. It's very interesting. There's so much more to talk about. I'm going to do more videos, but right now I'm sitting at the feet of the Holy Spirit, waiting, receiving, and petitioning. There's so many things to pray about, so many things that we need to destroy and clean up, and the Lord will see us through. He will. He is, because He is a good God. He is a good God. And as for me, I want to see His goodness while I'm still in the land of the living. God bless you.